We want to divide this degree 3 polynomial by this degree 2 binomial. And since a fraction bar represents division, we can write this as 2x cubed minus 8x squared plus 7x minus 13 divided by 2x squared plus 5. Notice how in the dividend, the terms are in descending order, meaning from highest degree to lowest degree, and all the terms from degree 3 to degree 0 are present. So to start this division, we're only concerned about the first term of the divisor and the first term of the dividend. And there are two ways to find the first term of our quotient or our answer. One way is to ask what times 2x squared would be equal to 2x to the third. If we know that would be x, then x would be the first term of a quotient. Or since we are performing division here, we can divide 2x cubed by 2x squared. And this would also equal x, our first term. Now we're going to multiply x in our divisor and put it below. So we'll have x times 2x squared, that's 2x cubed. And then we have x times 5, that's 5x. And we're going to put that underneath the x term so that like terms are lined up. So I'll have plus 5x here. But when performing long division, we need to subtract this result. But instead of subtracting this binomial, we're going to add the opposite, meaning we can change this to addition as long as we change the sign of both of these terms. So we can change this to plus as long as we change this to a negative and this to a negative. And now we'll add 2x cubed plus negative 2x cubed, that's 0. And then 7x plus negative 5x would be 2x. And then we'll bring down the next term, which is going to be this term here. So we'll have negative 8x squared. And this is positive, so we can write this as plus. And now we're only concerned about the first term of the divisor and this first term. And again, there's two ways to find the next term of our quotient. We can ask what times 2x squared would be equal to negative 8x squared. If we know that's negative 4, we can go up here and write minus 4. Or if we need to, we can divide negative 8x squared by 2x squared. Which is also equal to negative 4. And now we're going to multiply negative 4 with our divisor. So negative 4 times 2x to the second would be negative 8x squared. And then negative 4 times positive 5 is negative 20. So we have minus 20. And again, we're going to write this underneath the constant term in our dividend. So we'll write that over here. And now we need to subtract, but instead we're going to add the opposite. So again, we'll change this to addition, and then we'll change the sign of this term, and change the sign of this term. So now we can just add vertically. This would be 0. Bring down the x term, so we have 2x. And then we have negative 13 plus positive 20. That's going to be plus 7. Notice we've used all the terms now. And this is our remainder. Notice how the degree of the remainder is less than the degree of the divisor. So we'll have plus a remainder of 2x plus 7 all over our divisor of 2x squared plus 5. So this is the result of our division, which is called the quotient.